you know, the barbershop is real iconic, you know, in America. It's, you know, it's very Americana. So now people are going to be able to see what it's like inside the barbershop day in and day out. And the way we come across is, you know, one of those guys next doors that anybody can relate to. So I feel that everybody would be, you know, will have that connection with us. And it's just going to be real entertaining for everybody. You know, we're normal guys, the average guys from a small town in Pennsylvania. This is the last thing that I ever thought that I'd ever do. So to be able to experience something like that has just opened me up and just real grateful of it. You know, it's something that is a dream come true, once in a lifetime opportunity.
And like,
so
we look at it, we're not just doing it for just our own shop. We're not just doing this just for us. It's for all the other barbershops all around the nation. Like, there's millions of barbershops out here, and like, they all do wonderful work, not just us. And then we just want to be able to showcase that. And here's a great example, a great way to show how crazy you are, or somebody's personality. Like, for example, if you're crazy, you do crazy haircuts to your hair, and people don't even know you. They just look at you and be like, that guy's a little crazy. Or like, you want to be more sophisticated, you get a sophisticated haircut. They don't know you at all, but just by the way your appearance is, and the way you hold yourself and carry yourself, they look at you and be like, it looks like he's somebody important, even though he's not, but the haircut will do it. So people like taking a lot of chances nowadays, like doing designs in the beard, doing crazy haircuts, like bald on the side, long on the top, like, and nobody's really judging it because it's looking good on people or something. I don't know if I'm funny for everybody, but I like to find myself more entertainment, and like, I just try to make people feel comfortable and feel good. So like, I know like if somebody's sitting there, I don't like nobody with a sad face on, I try to always cheer them up. So for me, it's just more my nature and the way I actually am. So it's more legit for me. It's like, it's not hard at all for me to do it. If I see somebody sad, even if I don't know you, or even if you're not in the barbershop, I just try to make somebody cheer up. I always try to crack a joke or do something that makes somebody laugh.
Right.
Doesn't matter where they're at or who it is, old, young, kids. I just love doing it, so.
Right. My advice for them is just to be open, man. We're there to help you out. You know, whatever you want, let us know. And just to be open about something. If there's something that you want to try, man, it's hair grows back. Just try it, man. You know,
also, another advice is, if the barber's telling you not to do it,
don't do it.
For the most part, don't do it. We've been doing this for over a couple. For the most part, every barber's been doing it for over 5 years, and we know what we're talking about. So if we're telling you don't do something,
don't do it.
But if you keep insisting it, we'll do it because we're here to cater to you guys, to cater to the clients. Right. But listen to your barber; they know better.
Yeah. Two choices, okay. Roberto Rodriguez or Danny Trejo.
Ooh, Danny. Good one. Danny Trejo,
Danny.
Yeah.
I seen what he does.
Yeah,
I seen a lot of movies.
If I mess up and he pulls out that machete, I'm done.
Yeah.
I'll be done.
I'm scared of Danny.
Robert looks like he would just, like, if a bad haircut, probably be like,
you're fired.
I'll just wear a hat. Danny would look like he'll pull the machete out.
I won't get him. Like, I'll give him to him. I'll be like, you're cutting Danny. I'll cut double off. Bobby Rodriguez.